But as Julia Gillard pointed out several times this week, former Liberal Prime Minister John Howard wanted to put a price on carbon dioxide too. Joining me is former Treasurer Peter Costello. Peter, Julia Gillard has been using this line to embarrass the Liberals. Should John Howard finally say, sorry, I got it wrong?
Well, sorry is not the kind of word that John Howard uses. and the first journalist to get him to say sorry, I think, wins the Pulitzer Prize. So let's put that to one side. It's true that the Liberal Party ran to the 2007 election with an emissions trading scheme as part of its policy. The Labor Party at the time said that wasn't strong enough, that it should be much more aggressive, that it should be brought in earlier, and all the rest of it. But I think that as this debate has wound on, as people have actually become aware of what this involves, there'd be very few Liberals today that would support an emissions trading scheme. And I think from John Howard's perspective, he'd be entitled to say, look, I put that as a policy. I now know what the consequences are. The consequences are far more draconian than I ever thought they'd be. I've changed my mind.
I was wrong. Thatcher did it. Why can't he do it?
Well, I don't think that's a problem. My own view is that the Liberal Party made a critical error in the lead-up to 2007. The big issue was whether or not to ratify Kyoto, which we should have agreed to, and which we met. Having not done that, we went 10 bridges too far with a ill-considered policy. And, of course, that was the policy that Malcolm Turnbull was later able to say that he had to defend in order to get rid of Brendan Nelson.
Yes, and Malcolm Turnbull obviously is trying to still exploit this thing that John Howard did too. I'm just wondering, at this time of where the economy is now and with the foreign troubles, American so much trouble, Greece, Italy, Spain, Ireland, it doesn't seem to me to make any sense at all to bring in an ETS tax on our emissions.
Well, let's boil this all down. I mean, what this is all about is taking away a natural advantage of Australia. It's essentially about handicapping our cheap electricity, which comes through coal. That's what Australia is doing. And then we have this massive expenditure on the other side to try and buy ourselves out of all of the consequences. So we put a penalty on coal mines, and then we set up a fund to protect gaseous coal mines. We put a penalty on coal energy, and then we try and protect our steel and aluminium industries that rely upon it. And the interesting thing I find is I don't find anybody else in the world that takes this attitude. I don't find powers in the Middle East, for example, arguing that oil should be priced up to try and reduce reliance on oil. I don't see the Russians that are saying there should be a tax on gas to try and price Russian gas out of the market. What I see is a country bravely beating along to the agenda of some ideological people, in this case the Socialist Left, the ALP and the Greens, to take away what is a natural advantage. And this, I think, is the big thing. I've heard Gillard argue that this is an economic reform. Now, every economic reform worth its name over the last 30 years has been designed to improve the efficiency of the Australian economy. This is the first, in my recollection, which is designed to prove inefficiencies.
How much will this hurt us?
Oh, well, this, according to the Treasury model, it'll reduce our income about 10% per annum over the period up to 2020. And the other thing that's very, very interesting in all of this, and I think it's come out in the commentary, is most of the abatement, by the way, is premised on the fact that we'll buy permits from someone else.
Send it to China or Nigeria.
That's right. We have to buy permits for something like 100 million tonnes of carbon dioxide. Now, first of all, who's going to be issuing these permits? Which countries? Who's going to be auditing them? Who's going to be making sure that they're real? Secondly, of course, at the end of the day, what happens is we're paying someone else for the right to use our own coal.
It's crazy. In short, we've got to go, but can Julia Gillard sell this?
Oh, no. Anything that Gillard touches turns to dust.
Is she finished?
I actually think that she's killing this. There's a lot of people think that this is killing her. I think she's killing this. And Andrew, as an old poll, by the time you're getting cleaned up in the shopping malls of Brisbane by disinterested shoppers, you're politically dead. And of course, for Julia, she had to go back to a place of refuge, which was the Canberra Press Gallery, to try and recharge her batteries.
Peter Costello, thank you very much for joining me.